such a presence of God in this house. And I'll tell you something, that God doesn't show up just to show up. He shows up when there is hunger for his presence. And if you haven't arrived in this place hungry for his presence, maybe you came spectating, look at your neighbor and say thank you, because your hunger is provoking our God to be here. And I encourage you to desire his presence as well. I love what God is doing in this house and what he is doing through this generation. And what we are most in need of is not for a touch from God. Because in an atmosphere like here, God is here, and whoever is willing, God will touch you. But we do not need a touch from God. We need God to dwell within our very being. Are you wondering why you fall into the same sin, into the same mistakes, into the same routine? It's because you only get touched by God. But what you need is God to live, breathe, and dwell within your spirit. I'm not here to preach, so don't worry. But I just gave birth to my son a month and a day ago. And from that situation, I've learned so much that when you have intimacy with God, there is always, always something to show for it. Always. You will always birth something after you've been intimate with your God. When God touches you, nothing comes from it. You can go back and do the same things. But when you have an encounter with God, when the heavens open and he pours out the blessing that has your very name on it, you will never, ever, ever be the same. And I guarantee you, whether it's 9 days, whether it's 9 months, whether it's 9 years, whether it's when you're 90, you will birth something. You will birth life, and you will birth a blessing into your life that will bless others. That is the way that our God works. So tonight I know that we have worshiped to our heart's content, and God is already here. You have already provoked him to be here. But I just want to invite you to go a little further tonight. I'm not here to put on a show. I am here that we may all be ministered to have the Lord open the gates of heaven and just pour out a blessing like never before. There where you are, just close your eyes and lift up your hands and say, God, I welcome you into my heart right now, oh Lord. Whether it's been the first day that you've come into a building like this one, or whether it's been a year that you have been in this walk, say, God, I welcome you into the very being of my soul, God. I don't want you to touch me like you've touched me before, God. I don't want to just simply feel a breeze of you, God. I want you to make my soul your home. I want you to make my soul your living place, oh God, that your name may be glorified, that your name may be exalted through my life. God, that I may birth revival, that I may birth revival for my city in Jesus' name. Dios, bienvenido a este lugar y en nuestro corazón venías tu voluntad. Te queremos conocer con tu fuego abrasador. Ven y muévete otra vez. Espíritu, avívanos, te anhelamos. Thank you. se abra el cielo. Muévete, Señor. Venga aquí tu reino. Oh, gran Dios. Somebody say, let the heavens open. Let your kingdom move. In our great God, yes, se abra el cielo, muévete, Señor, venga aquí tu reino, oh gran Dios, que se abra el cielo, muévete, Señor, venga aquí tu reino. If you are in need of open heavens, why don't you run to this place right now? It does not matter what the order is. God is in this house right now. And he is saying, if you take that step of faith, God is going to move mountains in your favor. God is going to bring revival unto your spirit. He is going to impregnate you with revival in this house. Yeah, yeah. Señor, es un tabernáculo de adoración en este momento. Come on, lift up your hands and just give him all of the praise and the honor, because God has done something mighty and wonderful within you. Su voz en esta noche y decirle al Señor que renueve su corazón, un fuego que consuma todo por ti, y con los cielos cantaré, eres el rey. Vamos. Give him a loud clap tonight.